morning everyone, welcome to the vlog for August. I hope you guys are all going well. I'm just getting set up for the morning. It is Monday, August the 2nd. I've already done a few posts and organised some things for later in the week. And now I get to work on the digital print for this month's Patreon reward. But yeah, it's been a pretty good weekend. Speaking of Patreon, I yesterday went out and had a nice relaxing walk, and I stopped in at the warehouse on the way home and found these New Zealand themed washi tapes, so that's pretty exciting. I'm going to use those to wrap up some Patreon parcels. I think they're very, very cute, and also this one's just for me. It's got some flowers and bees on it. And the other thing I got yesterday is a little dice, so I'm going to use this on stream so I can choose the activities for the subdoodles. When I'm streaming and someone subscribes, they get a little doodle from me, and I've been choosing various animals with a spin wheel tool that I use on stream. But I also like to choose the activities that the animal is doing, and there's just not enough space on the spin wheel for that, plus the animals, and we keep getting double up. So we're going to have a spin wheel choice for just the animals, and then this dice I can spin to choose an activity, so there should be no double ups and it will take less time, I hope. Anyway, I'm going to try that out in the stream later today, but now I have to get on and do some drawing. And also I've been having a look at this book, so let me just move my iPad over here. So yeah, I've been having a quick look at this atmospheric watercolours book by Jean Haynes. I've been trying out a few different things, so I'm hoping to spend a little bit of time this month working on different types of watercolour styles and having a bit more fun with stuff. It might be nice to try something a bit looser this month, so that's what I'm going to try and do. And this is the book I will be using to try and learn a few new techniques and things like that, so pretty excited. Okay, I'm gonna go do some digital art, and yeah, I will update you guys later. We went on a quick visit to the zoo, and I was very happy to see that work is progressing on the new snow leopard enclosure. The snow leopards are supposed to be arriving in late 2021 or early 2022, and I can't wait to see if eventually the zoo offers a close encounter once they are settled in. Thank you. year, I like to look for planners that will help me plan for the first part of the next year. I found these undated planners at Daiso. I'm not sure if they will be useful for planning my art projects, but I thought I would try them out. I really enjoy pattern design and I wanted to complete a half-finished deer design that I had sitting on my iPad. I ended up finishing the pattern and then creating a coordinate with just the deer on a pink background. For August's Patreon print, I went with a study of a rosy maple moth. The rosy maple moth inspired me to research other fluffy types of moths and then start my new opera moth painting series. Here I have already added graphite to the back of a scan of my drawing and taped it into my watercolour sketchbook. When I trace over the top of the sketch, the graphite on the back of the paper is transferred to the sketchbook page. I can add water to the sketchbook page so that the paint spreads evenly on the paper. I add a nice even layer of water so that the paper is wet, but there's no pools of water. Now I can add a little bit of paint at a time, creating a nice even wash of colour. Once the first layer of paint was dry, I wanted to add some masking fluid to the veins on the wings. This way I can paint more layers straight over the top and then remove the masking fluid later on to reveal the lighter sections underneath. I thought I would try using this clay shaping tool to apply the masking fluid as it would be easy to clean the latex off. The wedge shape of the shaping tool turned out to be very good for masking out the finer veins on the wings. I used to have a ruling pen that came in a set with this masking fluid, but I seem to have misplaced it. I would definitely use this clay shaper tool again though, as it worked really well. created these cute postcards to go with the print in Procreate on the iPad. And here's how the print turned out after many more watercolour layers and the addition of a background. All of the prints were trimmed and stamped with an edition number and signature. Shortly after this, we went back into lockdown here in New Zealand, so the rest of August was spent creating more art at home and streaming. I was preparing for the Twitch ANZ Winter Creative Showcase, which was super fun, and I really enjoyed meeting new people and chatting about my art. I hope you enjoyed this shorter vlog. I will be back again soon with another art video. See you next time!